Listening Library presents Revenge of the Living Ted by Barry Hutchison. Read for you by Sophie Amoss. One. Lisa Marie woke with a start from a bad dream, sat up suddenly, and immediately headbutted her older brother. Thunk. Ow, she said, which coincidentally was exactly what her brother said.
What did you do that for?
Vernon demanded, rubbing the spot on his forehead where Lisa Marie had clonked him.
I didn't do it on purpose, Lisa Marie retorted.
She looked around at her neat and tidy bedroom.
Why are you in my room? What were you doing leaning over me? Were you going to shout in my ear to wake me up?
Vernon looked hurt.
I can't believe you think I'd do that to you.
You do it at least once a week,
Lisa Marie pointed out. Vernon smirked.
Oh, yeah, so I do.
The smirk became a full-blown grin.
Okay. You got me.
Lisa Marie shuffled back so she was sitting upright in bed. She yawned, stretched, and studied her stepbrother. Are you okay? She asked.
I think so, said Vernon. But it might leave a lump.
Not your head, Lisa Marie said. I mean, are you okay after last night?
Vernon blinked. What?
Why? What happened last night?
Lisa
Marie's voice became a shrill whisper.
What do you mean, what happened last night? The teddy bears. You don't remember?
Vernon raised one eyebrow.
Teddy bears? I don't know what you're talking about, he said.
Lisa Marie gasped.
What? But...
Vernon's face split into a grin.
Sorry, couldn't resist. You should see your face, he laughed. Yes, I remember.
He shivered, recalling the army of evil teddy bears that had almost been the end of both of them.
How could I forget something like that?
Lisa Marie relaxed.
And you're okay?
Vernon nodded.
Think so. Yeah, I mean, it was all a bit...
discombobulating?
Lisa Marie guessed.
Big words were one of her favorite things, and discombobulating was one of her favorite big words. I have no idea what that means, Vernon admitted.
It sort of means disconcerting, Lisa Marie explained.
Vernon continued to look at her.
Lisa Marie sighed.
Confusing.
Right, gotcha. Couldn't you just have said that in the first place?
Asked Vernon.
I was going to say terrifying, but yeah, it was disco bobbing or whatever, too.
Lisa Marie didn't bother trying to correct him. He was probably saying it wrong on purpose to annoy her.
And yes, I'm fine, Vernon said.
You? Lisa Marie reached for her glasses, which were sitting on her bedside table. She pulled them on, then nodded.
I'm okay, she confirmed.
And she was. It was surprising how okay she was, really. She'd been woken up just after midnight last night by Henrietta, the witch bear she'd made at the Create a Ted shop, and had watched helplessly as her dad and stepmom had been turned into a frog and a slug. From there, things had quickly gotten even worse, thanks to Vernon's demon vampire werewolf bear, Grizz, and his army of evil Teds. Luckily, Lisa Marie, Vernon, and a very special teddy named Bearvis had worked together to stop Grizz's evil plan. They definitely saved the town, and probably the whole world. It was a good thing it had been a Friday night, so she didn't have to get up early the next morning for...
She sat forward suddenly in bed.
Thunk. Ow! Will you stop doing that? Vernon yelped, rubbing his forehead again.
It's Saturday, Lisa Marie said. Morning! It's Saturday morning!
And that's a good reason to headbutt me?
It's the first. It's the first of November.
Vernon began to frown, but his eyebrows worked out what Lisa Marie meant before his brain did and quickly went into reverse.
Yeah, what's...
he gasped.
Dad's birthday! I mean, your dad's birthday! I mean, Steve's birthday! I mean...
I know what you mean, Lisa Marie told him.
She threw back her covers and swung her legs out of bed, forcing Vernon to jump to his feet.
Let's go and wish him a happy birthday.
Vernon nodded.
Okay,
he said. Then he chewed his lip.
Think he remembers being a frog?
Not sure,
Lisa Marie admitted, taking her bathrobe off the back of her door.
Think Mom remembers being a slug?
Vernon puffed out his cheeks.
Don't know,
he said. But I guess there's only one way to find out.
2.
Lisa Marie had many impressive skills. Knowing science facts off the top of her head, solving crossword puzzles, and saving the world from evil stuffed toys, to name but three. Singing, however, was not one of them. She stood in the middle of the living room, screeching her way through Happy Birthday, while Vernon mumbled half-heartedly along with her. As they reached the Dear Dad part, Lisa Marie's voice almost shattered the light bulb and forced Vernon to plug his ears with his pinky fingers. When the song was finally over, Lisa Marie threw her arms around her dad's waist, then presented him with the card she had made. Because she was almost as bad at art as she was at singing, she decided to cut letters out of a magazine to spell out the message on the front. It had seemed like a good idea at the time, but as she handed it over, she couldn't help but feel it looked like something a kidnapper might send to demand a ransom.
Thank you, sweetheart. It's very creative, Dad said, setting the card in pride of place on the mantelpiece.
Vernon snorted.
How much do they want for the hostages, Steve? He asked.
And where are you supposed to leave the money? Vernon's mom, Lisa Marie's stepmom, shot Vernon a playfully stern look.
I suppose your card is a work of art, is it? She asked.
I didn't make a card, Vernon said. But we did get you a present, and I helped pay for it, even though we could have got you one for free.
Dad looked a little confused.
Okay. Thanks.
Don't mention it, said Vernon. Lisa Marie opened the living room cupboard and pulled out a box. It was quite a bashed and battered box, with several tears in the wrapping paper that had been clumsily taped back together. She clutched it to her chest for a moment, like she didn't really want to hand it over.
Am I getting it then? Dad asked.
Yep,
said Lisa Marie, but she kept hugging the box. Dad smiled.
When? Next birthday? He teased.
Forcing her fingers to release their grip, Lisa Marie reluctantly passed the box to her dad. He noticed the damaged wrapping for the first time and eyed the package warily.
Happy birthday, Lisa Marie said. Again, I hope you like it.
I'm sure I'll love it, Dad replied,
looking just a little nervous as he tugged on the torn wrapping paper. His eyes grew wider when he saw the clear plastic window of the box inside.
No, he gasped. You didn't.
Staring out from inside the box was a teddy bear. Not just any teddy bear, though. It was a bear styled on Dad's all-time favorite singer, Elvis Presley.
Elvis, Dad laughed.
Technically, his name's Bearvis, said Lisa Marie. The shop wasn't allowed to call him Elvis.
For legal reasons, Vernon said. He shrugged, or so the shop guy said.
But anyway, he prefers to be called the King, Lisa Marie concluded.
Dad chuckled,
I bet he does.
Prying open the box lid, he pulled the teddy bear out. It wore a white jumpsuit and matching cape, both of which were covered in shiny sequins. His hair was sleek black and teased up into an impressive pompadour. At least, that's how he was supposed to look. In reality, his outfit was quite badly stained with dirt and soot, and there was a perfectly round hole through his hair, as if someone had shot at it with a ray gun.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.